Customization of input type file. This is the part that we are going to learn about today in this tutorial. Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn about customization of input file type. Here, this is the project that has been created so far. So this will be the final output, and we have to do it from here. Now, before making any kind of such coding, we have to clear one thing, that there are numerous ways to practically customize this kind of input file type, but we will be first heading to a very simple approach on this project, and in this occasion we'll be making it quick and effective one. So this is the main motto of this tutorial. Now let's get back to our tutorial, and here in this div class form group we can see that an input type file has been created over here, clearly with an ID and with a class form control. Now what we have to do, we have to first create a label class here. We will be naming it as custom upload, and we will put everything inside this label class. Now first of all, let's create this class here. We are getting back to custom.css. Now as we do not need to mention this .banner7 over here, as this is not a default class being defined by Bootstrap format, so we may create the same class over here, which is known as .custom upload. And now we have to on the other hand, in this index.html, all we need to do here, and we need to do another thing. First of all, select this one, where we are mentioning this property as display none. Now if we get back to our project and reload, now we can see that this thing has been created over here, the box has been created over here, but still it is not showing any properties. But on clicking this, we can see that the dialog box which is required in this purpose is getting opened. So we have successfully changed the design of this custom file upload of this input file type text, but there's still now many problems out there, as we can see, so we have to fix up those problems. Now here we can see an anomaly, that we are presenting this color formation here as white, but still if we observe it into our project, we can see that the color is still red. This is due to the fact that you have previously mentioned here it is, in this banner7 level, that the color of the text formats will be red. You want to make it a white color, so this is why the necessity of this syntax comes forward. You have to put it over here as important, and on the other hand you have to change here the background property, and we are making some more customization, such as we are providing a box shadow property, and we are providing here a border radius of 4 pixels. So now we are prepared, pressing Ctrl S, get back to our project and reload. And now we can see that our customization is done over here. We have successfully changed this background color property, this text color property, our font color property over here, and everything is changed here. And the last thing that needed to be done, here it is. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project, and now you can see that your cursor changes its properties. Instead of showing an arrow over here, it is now showing a hand that should have been appeared in case of any kind of links. Now the last thing that we can see over here is this eye icon. So this is what we need to bring up over here. That is why we are getting back to our project, and here, first of all, get back to index.html. All you need to do, you need to include a span class. Okay, we are now good to go. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project, and you can see that a handsome eye is being appearing over here. beside this upload file here, text. So this is it. This is what we wanted to know. If you want to customize this particular part, this I part, or if you want to bring some other kind of icons over here, then all you need to do, you need to get back to your components. From here, from this variety of lists, you can select any kind of icon wishing to use in this segment. So this is it. This is how you will be achieving anything you want. This is how you will be customizing your font elements over here. I hope you have liked this tutorial, and if you have truly liked our video, then do not hesitate to share it. So hope this tutorial will aid you to customize your own projects, your own form elements into your Bootstrap theme. If you have liked our tutorial video, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.